What's up, guys? I want to make a video because I have something to share, obviously, but I thought I'd been sort of neglecting a YouTube channel, like video, making video media and sort of a website a little bit as well. I've been more like on social media. So I just thought I'd make this quick video concerning this something I seen about maybe a month ago now, and it was this guy who'd been studying the signs in the heavens and events history mainly, and I've been doing a lot of studying the signs in the heavens, like the eclipses, the blood moon. Daniel Taylor kind of set me off on it, and I've sort of extended the research a bit further, and yeah, I've got something else to share about that, but that's another video. Again, like I say, I've sort of been slacking a little bit, you know, so I've got a few videos, a few articles that I need to do. But anyway, looking at this first one, was this guy was studying the signs in the heavens concerning World War II, and he there was a blood moon in November on 1988, and then into the next year there was a full solar eclipse in April 1989, which is about 5 months apart. And then pretty much about 5 months on from then, he says that's when, according to his research, the war began at the 1st of September 1989. Now, the thing is that he's saying that the signs, the heavenly signs, and the actual days and months which they fell on are pretty much exactly the same. So what he's saying is we had a blood moon in November, and it was literally 2 days, one day after the 1988 blood moon in November. So we had a blood moon in 2022. I remember this one because I was speaking to a lady from America at the time, and I remember talking about this blood moon and how it's special because it was actually going to, the phase of it going blood moon would actually be the same time of the day that the throne of God would pass over. So when the throne of God would pass, it would hit Earth, and the Earth would roll round at noon time in Israel, which is 10 a.m. UK time, which is 3 a.m. US time. So the exact time that the moon was going blood red was the time that the throne would be rolling the Earth around during that six seal throne passing. So, and she started crying. I was like, no, I'm not saying that that's going to happen. I'm saying that it's quite amazing that it's the same time of the day. Like, so we had that blood moon, November, beginning of November. And then we had just recently, I mean, we shared about it, and it passed over northwestern Australia, it was seen. But there was a full total solar eclipse, and people were saying that it's some sort of hybrid special eclipse, whatever, but it literally happened the same day and month as it did in 1989. I mean, literally days apart. I think it was ours was the 20th, I think, in 1989. It was the 19th of April. And so by the cycle of the moons, basically he's expecting World War III to begin around, I mean, specifically, it would be the 2nd of September, but around September, they're expecting this cycle is predicting that World War III will begin. Now beginning, because the war starts in the seals, seal number two. All right, so you've got seal number one, the Antichrist is crowned king. Then 40 to 30 days it will be until the throne hits at seal six. But then seal number two, war begins. So I believe really this is what it's talking about. And but just to mention though, because this is the Roman calendar. All right, it's okay on the Roman calendar, but this might be totally different on the Hebrew calendar. But I look back, you see, and I went and did my research and I looked in 1989 and it was like Passover was on the 5th of April. And just by memory, I knew, yeah, it was on the 5th of April because the full moons are literally the first week of the Roman calendar. So our Passover was around the 5th of April. So the Hebrew calendar lining up in 1989 was exactly as it is in 2023, if that makes sense. So this is not, these blood moons and these eclipses are not falling on Roman days, they're falling on Hebrew days too. Do you see what I mean? So, so we had the total solar eclipse on mid-April. So 5 months on is when World War II began in September, the beginning of September, the first day of September. So this is really predicting that we're to be looking at September as being the war beginning. To me though, that would be seal two. But you might say, well, you know, moon signs and all this, is there anything? Because I wouldn't just go and believe something. Like if someone coming down and said, blah, 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 yeah, yeah, I think just because that star sign, war's going to begin in July, then, you know, I'd have to have some sort of other evidence to suggest that could be right. And what is there? But then you look at September. The beginning of September is a full moon, by the way, as well. So the first day, actually, there's two moons in August. There's one on August the 1st and there's one on August the 31st, whatever, it's the last day of August. So that was known as a blue moon. That is the day that this cycle is expecting World War III to begin. All right, so you have a blue moon, and then you have the beginning of September, you have this prediction that war is going to outbreak. All right, which to me, like I said, would be seal two. So for this to be correct in any sort of way, don't think that you'll have to wait until September, because guess what? Seal number one has to happen first. And seal number one is King William, Prince William becoming King William. Sitting on the throne of David. Well, of course, we know that his dad has just taken the throne properly. Now he is king. Not 6 months ago when people said, "Oh, he's king." I was like, "No, he's paper king." But now he has sat on the throne of David. He's took the scepter of the kingdom. He's put the crown on his head, and he is now the king, and actually the head of the Scarlet Beast Empire. And it was Babylon the great woman, whore, that came with the power that they have. They have power over the kings of the earth, it says. That city, Rome. And a representative of Rome, the Archbishop of Canterbury, has to put that crown on his head because they have power over the kings of the earth. And so the Archbishop of Canterbury, which is a representative of Babylon the Great, put the crown of power onto Charles's head, who has now become actually the head of the Scarlet Beast. And I don't know what it is within the witchcraft and the Freemasons, but really he is now actually the head of the Illuminati too, the top of the pyramid. And by the way, the pyramid, the one-eye pyramid, is for Horus. Horus is the firstborn son to Isis. Who, by the way, they call Diana Isis. So do you get me? Do you see the bigger picture here? And why everything points to William? But like I said, for the war outbreak to begin in September anyway, getting back to it, you would have to say William would have to be crowned first. I know, looking at it, actually seems like a short time. Why would they bring a king in and 5 months later bring a new king in? So, I mean, but to me, looking at Bible prophecy, you know, they can say it's a star sign, they can say it's history repeating itself, but to me, until that seal number one happens, then seal two can't happen in September either, war outbreak. Do you get me? And actually, I can go back even further than that, and for seal number one to happen, the inheritance event has to happen first. I won't go into it, otherwise this video is going to be so long, like, but, you know, the inheritance event has to happen first. The angel has to cry out, who is worthy? No man's found worthy, because he's still in his manger. From 2017 when he was born. Israel has to say, Baruch haba b'shem Adonai, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. He's then brought forward to the throne. Revelation 12 continues, Revelation 5 is fulfilled. And all the free celebrations in heaven, where they say, thou art worthy to take the book and to loose the seven seals thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation, because he's been brought forward from his manger up to the throne. And then the second celebration, all the angels come about and they say, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. And it says, and all the creatures which are in the heavens, on earth, under the earth, nocturnals, and such like that are in the sea or in the waters, all started singing with a loud voice, saying, blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him who sits upon the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. And then the four beasts in heaven say, amen, and they fall down and worship. And you're going to hear that, because we're going to hear that third celebration, all the creatures which are in the heavens, on earth, and under the earth, and there. So we're going to hear that inheritance event happen. And then that'll trigger that, because then you'll know, hey, the seven seals have been given over to Jesus Christ by God from the right hand, and he actually sits at the right hand of his throne then, only when Revelation 5 is complete. And then it comes on to bringing forward the seven seals, of which number one is William the Antichrist being crowned king. Do you know what I mean? So these things have got to happen, I believe. And if this thing is right about him predicting World War III to be starting in September, then obviously William has to be king before then. And so, yeah, that's it's just a marker point. Ah, so I, you know, I'm not, like I said before, I'm not one to think, you know, someone's just give me a star sign and it points to that month. Like, say, if it was July, or points to July, okay, I believe you, then the war outbreak's going to begin. That means the seals are going to happen in that month. No, I need more to confirm it. Do you know what I mean? And there's a few things now in September, all right? Like I said, beginning of September, you have the full moon. You have this predicted day of the war outbreaking. If it does, around that full moon, okay. The Antichrist must be crowned first, though. So if war outbreaks, which is seal two, but then a 1 week later, guess what? It's the 23rd of Elul, which is the day the markets collapse. There's a Shemitah cycle, which in ancient times, the Hebrews were told to rest the land on the seventh year, not grow anything, don't be greedy, let the land rest and everything else. But in our time, it has become a year of market collapse. And it's a cycle, and it's a 7 year cycle. You can go from 9/11. The market crashed after 9/11. 7 years later, in 2008, the market collapsed. I know, I lost thousands. I started my own business, still wasn't saved. 7 years on, you get to 2015. I'm saved in 2013. I recognize it coming. I was listening to Jonathan Kahn. I learned about Shemitah and seen it coming. 7 years later, you get to 2022, Elul 23rd. Guess what day that was? The market didn't crash, obviously, because the seals haven't happened, obviously. But guess what? It was the Queen's funeral. And the market blipped on that very day, by the way, but it wasn't enough to call it a crash, to be a crash. And of course, again, I told you, the seals haven't happened yet and the market's recovered a bit. But now we're coming full circle. We're coming 1 year later. And someone told me that the markets have been delayed of the crash because it's the Jubilee year. I thought Jubilee year was 2017 because you have 1917, the family of the Antichrist, the British royal family, made a place for the Jews to live in Palestine and made the Balfour Declaration that the Jews can live here. And you know, I guess all the Muslims sort of obeyed, unless they wanted to be invaded again, like, you know, World War One kind of thing. So they allowed it. 50 year Jubilee later, we had the 1967, the 3 day war. Jews literally took Jerusalem and the Temple Mount. But obviously the Temple Mount is still in the control of the King of Jordan at this time. 50 years later, and you come to us now, don't you? And you come to the book of Revelation, you come to the sign in the heavens, 2017, in which the man child was born. In the heavens. So that, I thought that was a Jubilee because of that 50 year cycle, but I don't know, maybe this person who told me, or I don't even remember who it was just on social media somewhere, that it's a Jubilee and it's been delayed. Well, the fact of the matter is it has been delayed. But like I say, we're coming now full circle, and as we start to get more towards September again, you have this guy with this cycle of wars beginning. And Then you have, 1 week later, you have Elul 23rd, which is when the markets collapse in that time of the year. And if it was delayed 1 year, guess what? Elul 23rd, 1 week pretty much into September, is literally 1 year since the Queen's funeral also. So then, you know what I mean? You have suspected the beginning of SEAL 2 war outbreak, you have this, and you have the time of the year where SEAL 3 market collapse happens at the same point in the year. So that's what makes me think and triggers me to think and believe in this may possible cycle of the end of the age events beginning towards September, maybe mid-August, September through. And because of, like I say, time of market collapse, that cycle. But there's other stuff as well. You have the United Nations coming together at the end of the year. Like last year, someone was going on about Daniel 9:27, and it is a 7-year agreement. And this 7-year agreement is going to happen before the throne hits at the sixth seal on the full moon. All right. And then last year I was like, and then it came round to it, and the United Nations, because what he was saying is Daniel 9:27, ninth month of the Roman calendar, September, 27th day, boom. And I watched it, and they're all saying last year, September 27th, around that time, they're all saying peace and safety, climate change, peace and safety, climate change. And that's all they were going on about. Well, guess what? It's all going to happen again this year. All right. So this, and that is the time where they would come together and make a peace agreement. See what I mean? And it fits in with the end of September. And guess what? 9:27. A couple of days later, you have the Feast of Tabernacles, the Feast of Tents. On a full moon. So, you know, and if it all fits in. I mean, the perfect time for God's throne to pass over the first time, at least, would be the Feast of Tabernacles, because if you literally if you physically keep the Feast of Tabernacles and you physically go into the mountains, into the wilderness, and you kept that feast, and he passed over on that feast, full moon, which he's going to at seal number six, the full moon, and you knew nothing about these seals or anything, you're totally bewildered, but you just kept the Feast of Tabernacles, you would physically be saved. Let's say I pitched my tent here, Feast of Tabernacles, but I didn't believe in end of the age anymore. And it was to happen at September, like I say, up here, war outbreak, 1 week later, market collapse, seal 2 and 3. And let's say towards the end of the month, the United Nations come together, and let's say they make that 9:27 deal for 7 years. Sudden destruction comes upon them. 2-3 days later, it's Feast of Tabernacles, the 29th of September. So, do you see what I mean? And that's all happening in September. And that's not even all of it, because this war outbreaking, then you have SEAL 2 and 3 war outbreak, market collapse. And guess what? This is my own prophecy. I mean, I got it from IPEC Goat 2. But then the Dome of the Rock is going to be destroyed off the Temple Mount, obviously to build the Temple of God after. But that event, it has to happen after SEAL 2 and 3, market collapse, war outbreak. Then the Dome of the Rock is destroyed off the Temple Mount. And that's to pave the way for the building of the temple. You see what I mean? And remember, this is a war outbreak from Israel. Now, there's another thing, is that I keep a marker of the possible beginning of the 2300 day prophecy of a dirty temple, right? I keep a marker, and it's basically 2,300 days from there, that day, whatever day it was going to be, all the way into the future to a possible end time, full moon, end of the two witnesses, whatever. And like I said in my past video, I mean, if I was thinking that the two witnesses are going to be killed in Jerusalem towards a Christmas time because they make merry and they send gifts. So guess what? I've gone from the full blood moon, by the way, it's going to be a blood moon on December 20th, 2029. All right, which is also Tevet, which I need to make another video about this, which is the center stem, which held all the other blood moons up for 30 years. Tevet 14th, which will be December the 20th, 2029, becomes a full moon. Like I say, it's been 30 years, actually it's been 30 years pretty much since it happened before. And so it seems like a very special time, that 2029. But anyway, there's a marker in the calendar at the beginning, I believe, of September, around the beginning of September, and it says 2,300 days until that December full blood moon in 2029. So also I have a watch period for a dirty temple beginning, and this would be like the United Nations taking over the Temple Mount, or maybe even the Hebrews getting control of the Temple Mount. That might sound bad, because you might say, oh, well, they're entitled to it. It's God's temple. It's God's Temple Mount and everything else. But what you don't understand, this is through God's eyes. And there's people, there'll be people within that Israeli government that want to do evil. In fact, it even says it in Daniel, you know, he'll have, he will be speaking to people who forsake the Holy Covenant, basically to overthrow the temple and have William sit as the Messiah and be worshipped as a god. There's people in Israel, maybe perhaps within the government themselves, that want to bring about the Antichrist as the person of worship and world domination. Do you know what I mean? And it's not to build a house of God for prayer and everything else. It's basically to bring in the new world order and have the Antichrist rule the world from Israel, Jerusalem, but have him rule from the Temple Mount and be the person of worship for the world for the last 3.5 years. But all that will end, and like I said, 2,300 days. So in September, anyway, it will be a marker point in the beginning of September. There's a marker. It says 2,300 days from then until December full moon, Tevet 14th blood moon. All right. And then so, but I've also made markers for not just for the 2,300 days until the second passing of the throne, but until Armageddon, which happens 45 days after that. Just like Acts 1, he ascended 45 days after he was killed. You know, he was killed, and then 3.5 days later, which actually brings you into the fifth day, and 40 days he was on the earth and he ascended. So same thing's going to happen, but from the killing of the two witnesses. All right, so there's 45 days later will be Armageddon. So I've actually put a marker in for plus 45 days. But you can work it out. If there's a marker in place for September, saying 2,300 days until December 2029 moon, the Tevet, then obviously 45 days later will be the 45 plus 45. So probably around mid-October. Will be the other marker for a dirty temple. So, I mean, there's a window there. You know what I mean? There's a window and a very precise window. It'll be a high watch time, literally from beginning to midpoint of September through to the beginning midpoint of October for a dirty temple in God's eyes, i.e. temple mount control has changed. So anyway, there's all them things concerning this supposed September beginning of things. And remember, it's the beginning of September. And like I say, if that's seal two, then just know that it may even start in mid-August, because seal one has to come before seal two, you know. So anyway, I just wanted to share this. I hope it's I've gone on a little bit, but hey, do you know what? If my videos go more than, you know, 15, 20 minutes anymore, I don't really matter. I'm just going to try and get as much out there as I can. I listen, you know, see, even me, in which, like, God has gifted me with understanding prophecies of revelation, you know, I still listen to other people. I still listen to YouTube. I still listen to people send me things. I look at them. If it doesn't match with scripture, then I throw it away, kind of thing. But I still listen to people, do you know what I mean? And I can't remember the exact name of the YouTube, but he does a lot of study with the eclipses and world events. And there's more stuff, you know, that I haven't even covered in this video, like it being the just before World War I won't go into it because I don't know the full details. So I've just shared that with you. Just to recap, the same moon sequences are happening, suggesting that World War III is going to start at the beginning of September. I've looked at it. You've got blood, which means seal one has to happen before that. I've looked at it. You've got full moon, proposed world war outbreak, but then, you know, not coincidence, but then you have Elul 23rd, which is the time of a market collapse, which is 1 year delayed. All right, then you have a marker to watch out then for a dirty temple for 2300 days. That'll run for another 45 days. And then through September, and then towards the end of September, the United Nations are going to be gathering together again. Last year, they were saying peace and safety, climate change. So this might be the time of Daniel's 9:27 prophecy. And if it is, seal the 7-year agreement that comes before the throne hits, because then sudden destruction comes upon them. 2 days later, 3 days later, after that 2 days later is the 29th, which is a full moon, which God will pass over on a full moon. It is Feast of Tents, in which the people of God go into the wilderness or into the mountains even, and set up their tents for 7 days. So that's what I know. And like I said, I don't take one thing. I look at a whole bigger picture, and a massive picture is just evolving around September, which, you know, obviously is quite a few months away, but I'm sure time will fly, and we can do a lot of work before this happens. You know, I'd like to sort of refine my Exodus kit a bit more, maybe, you know, and some other stuff like long lines for fishing, and because if people don't understand the severity of it. I mean, he's going to interrupt nuclear World War III. He's going to destroy nations while he does. He can't bring his throne Nibiru close to earth, like, one, for the rapture to happen, and two, for the trumpet judgments to affect the earth. He has to bring Nibiru, his throne, past the earth, which it's going to just shake to bits in the presence of God. you know, from below, from above, and everything else. So, and you'll be lucky to survive. It's an extinction level event. That's why I tell people, flee into the mountains. I tell the East Coast, don't be on the East Coast, be in the Appalachians. Don't be on the Mississippi River Valley, I call it, all the way up to the Great Lakes. Don't be down that bit. Be in the Appalachians. Don't be on the West Coast of America. Be in the Denver Ridge, all right? I know the Illuminati are going to be hiding out there too, but at least you survive anyway. They'll be underground anyway. That's what the Bible says, that they're going to hide in the dens of the rocks of the mountains when the throne of God comes. Me, I'm going to be here like this, looking up into the sky, praising God. And then we're going to be sealed on our foreheads. The great multitude are going to be raptured. And saved, and then obviously the trumpet judgments, and then we go through the tribulation. Us, the 144,000, not the people who are repentant sinners before the throne hits. And so all you need to do is pray God and ask him to forgive you of your sins, and it is done. And through the shed blood of Jesus Christ, he has paid the price for your sin. And just like he rose from the dead, you will rise from the dead also. And you'll be resurrected at the first resurrection, and you rule this world. You come back and rule this world for 1,000 years with Jesus Christ. This is the Sabbath. This is the Sabbath millennium. The seventh millennium, 6,000 years humanity have been here. Don't listen to all that tush they teach you in science, but for 6,000 years humans have been on this earth. This earth has been this earth, and then for the seventh millennium we will rule it in peace and everything else, and with Jesus Christ as our king, our ruler. So God bless you all. I've been Pastor Prophet Justin Roberts from End of the Age Bible Prophecy. God bless you all. In Jesus' precious name, amen.